experiencing difficulty in the workplace.
Yeah.
And so that difficulty turned into a book. And that book is a 21-day devotional that served as a platform for me to eventually get here and meet you.
Well, when we met you, we knew that you were special, and we wanted to find out more. So we sat down. We had you on with Paris Ely on the magazine, so we got a chance to hear you, about you in the book. And then we actually had you on the live show with Paris and Carmen Watkins on the magazine. And so we found out that there was this unique ability to attract people to yourself. And we wanted to make sure that we gave opportunity to that and build a relationship that I believe others will benefit from also.
Well, I'd certainly appreciate you saying that. And that is definitely the type of energy that we have here at the station. And that's what we want to bring to the larger Houston audience.
It's
that,
a culture.
Yeah. That culture of community, that culture of family. And we want to help inform and educate as
Absolutely.
Well.
Absolutely.
And so that's why we're here today. So one of the things that we want to do is talk to our business family out there who need some answers when it comes to business. And we're talking about gaining clarity in your business today.
Mm.
So many folks want to start a business, or they're currently in business, but they feel lost in the process.
Well, you know, even if we go back to scripture, it said, you know, take the vision, write it down. But then it was one little part in it that make it plain.
Yes. Oh, my
make
goodness.
Make it plain. Give it clarity. Mm-hmm. And so certainly we think that those individuals will benefit from the clarity, being able just to look at it and say, okay, step one, step two, step three. And how do all these things come together? What do I need? And I think the clarity part is so important.
Absolutely. So when we talk about clarity, there are a few things that we want you all to know. And here are some facts. And these facts come from both Forbes and Entrepreneur magazine. And for those of you who are business owners or aspiring business owners, these are two very important media outlets that you want to make sure that you are partaking in. So the fact of the matter is that over 600,000 businesses are created each year. Astonishing, right? There's so many businesses that are created every year. However, the most daunting fact is that 8 out of 10 of those businesses will fail in the first 18 months.
Yes.
So tell me a little bit more about why you think that those 80% or that 80% of businesses fail.
Well, there's several reasons, but I think if we kind of just drill down and come from the 30,000 foot view of this whole thing, when you look at the very, very basic part of it, it's foundation.
Right.
Foundation. The things that are built on things that are not sustainable. So when you look at it, most businesses start out without proper operating capital at the front end.
Yeah.
And that's a problem when you're trying to grow a business and you have to operate out of receivables, and they're inconsistent in the first year for sure. And sometimes even into the second and third year.
Mm-hmm.
So if you don't have that necessary operating capital on the front end, you're trying to build infrastructure on the equipment side and personnel side, and you just don't have the finances. Then the other part, I believe, that causes the issues is the actual processes in place.
Right.
Where you don't know what you did, but you accomplish it, but you can't repeat it.
Right.
So you have to do it over. So it's a lot of start overs because the processes are not in place for intaking clients and relationship, managing those clients and relationship, and making sure that you can repeat that and qualify and make sure that you have the right quality of customer service on the front end of the relationship.
So money and systems is what it boils down
to. Money and systems. That's what it boils down to, it, man.
Yeah, so I definitely concur. I think that there's nothing like a broke business.
Oh.
If you have a broke business, then you inevitably will have to either start over or call it quits. And that's what we don't want to happen.
We don't want that to happen.
And that's where clarity comes in. Because if you're clear about what your mission and vision is for your business, then you'll know that it starts at that very baseline of how am I going to fund my business, all the way up to the other pieces that make you incredible amounts of money and give you incredible amounts of impact on the world and the community at large. So what I want to know is, how do you know if you're unclear in your business? What does that look like? What does that feel like? What does that sound like when you're unclear?
Well, the first thing you ask, everyone have to have this elevator pitch, if you would.
Yes.
So if I meet you and you tell me today, this is what you do. And you then the next time I meet you, and you still have the same business name, you still have the business card, but you give me a whole nother thing about what your company does.
Yes.
So I don't know when I meet you who I'm meeting. So I can't get brand congruency out of what you're talking about. So I don't know if should I call you for this or should I call you for that. So it's unclear what is your business? What do you provide? Is it a service? Is it a product? Well, I don't know.
Yeah.
So that clarity when you just not consistent in what you're presenting to the marketplace.
Yes, I like that word you use, congruency. So it's okay for us to be multi-passionate because
absolutely,
there are so many people out here who are skilled at different things and they want to be able to turn all of those things into a business.
Well, you
but what gets confusing is when you decide that you're going to lump all of those things together. I'm going to be a hairdresser and I'm going to be a professional speaker and I'm going to sell fish dinners. So well, you can't do all of those things.
Well, unless you're having a gala.
Yeah.
So certainly I think your passions are certainly important to the business because the thing that you're most passionate about, you'll find it a lot easier to do. But you have to make sure that your passion and your skill line up.
Right, absolutely.
Because you can be passionate about something and not skilled at it, and it'll cost you.
Right.
So it's, the investment in your passion is going to be so important to make sure that you get to qualify, get the necessary training, go to workshops, seminars. This internet thing is just so powerful.
Yeah.
So powerful. I go to University of, I think I have two certificates from YouTube University at least.
Oh, yes.
And so I use it because there's so many resources available for you on the web. And so you want to take advantage of that so you can drill down.
Right. And so that investment piece, you just keep dropping these nuggets. So that word investment, that's the investment of your time as well. If you're going to have a business and you want to be clear on that business, you have to invest the proper amount of time researching exactly what it is that you are going to do and do it well. So as Morris was saying, you can't just have 15 different things that you're great at and throw them all out at one time and see which one sticks. It's important for you to get laser focused on what it is that you want to accomplish and set those skills in order first. And that doesn't mean that you won't ever focus on anything else. That just means that people need to know you for something. And that's where branding comes in.
They have to be able to know when I want breakfast. Mm-hmm. I know the restaurants to go to because they serve what I like. And so I don't have to be confused about I'm going to go to that particular restaurant because they have what I want. And in business, you want to create that type of presence in the marketplace. And that's the word we're going to deal with also, Tiff, is presence.
Yeah.
So that's going to be important. Listen, you want to stay connected to the Business Breakfast talk show. This is going to be great. Tiffany has a wealth of information. She's doing a lot of research to bring us information. There's going to be special guests. That's a part of the breakfast talk show. Tiffany, I'm excited.
You know what? I am elated. And we are really building this thing out to be something that's super special for our Houston community. So if you haven't already invited a friend, go ahead and invite them to breakfast this morning so that they can get full with us. We have a full spread for you and we'll be back shortly. I think we're getting ready to take a break here, but we'll be back. And if you have any questions, go ahead and give us a call, 832-230-5592 here at KLVL.
Number 3 ranked high scoring Sam Houston State Bearcats and the Prairie View
Panthers. Roderick Dial PC, 713-862-4332. My name is Roderick Dial and I am a CPA, Certified Public Accountant. I'm in Houston and I will speak to you myself. I can assist you with unfiled tax returns, audits, appeals, installment agreements, payment plans, liens, levies on your wages, bank account, and other IRS problems. Don't speak to the IRS yourself. Get professional representation. We also do income tax preparation. We don't promise you we will settle your tax debt for pennies on the dollar. The IRS is not giving away the bank. If you are serious about your IRS matter, call me. If we represent you, you generally never speak or meet with the IRS. Call for your free 15-minute phone consultation. I'm Roderick, and I want to take this burden off your hands. 713-862-4332. 713-862-4332. I'm Roderick, and let me help you with your tax issue.
Hey, hey now, this is Amber Shaw inviting you to join me Sunday afternoons for Unplugged Praise. You'll get a dose of industry news, artist interviews, and music from some of your favorite artists such as John P. Key, Pastor Shirley Caesar, Marvin Sapp, and I can't forget about my Houston Gospel fam, Angela Bennett, Chad Brawley, Kathy Taylor, Wallace Grant II, and the list goes on and on. So tell your family, friends, and all your church members, Unplugged Praise is your kind of praise.
Unplugged Praise with Amber Shaw, Sundays 1 to 4 p.m. here on 1480 KLVL.
Hey, this is Tasha Evans, and I love to eat at great restaurants. And more than that, I love great desserts. So does Rashawn McDonald. Check out his new website. That's www.RashawnMcDonald.com. That's R-U-S-H-I-O-N, and McDonald is spelled just like the famous restaurant chain. Guys, Rashawn is looking for great bakers for his Baker Spotlight. He wants to brag on his fans for their incredible baking skills on his social media and website. That can be your mom, friend, coworker, or relative. Spread the word today. Visit RashawnMcDonald.com.
You're listening to KLVL 1480. It's radio at the next level.
And we are back. Welcome back, all of our Houston listeners. We are talking about how to gain more clarity in your business here on the Business Breakfast Talk Show. And you are joining both Tiffany, myself, and Mr. Morris Parsons. So before we went to break, we were talking a little bit about how we can be all over the place when it comes to business, right? But there are some critical mistakes that can be made when you move into business without clarity. And we talked about a few of those things. So that also includes overspending in your business, confused customers like you were talking about, overwhelm and poor leadership. So that's what we were talking about a little bit before we went to break. Now, I want to mention to you that clarity means that you have a strong vision and a solid plan.
That's correct.
And clarity also equals momentum and sustainability.
Now let's go back to that momentum piece.
Yeah.
A lot of times we miss the importance of momentum.
Mm-hmm.
And as a leader, you have to know how to sense when momentum is shifting. They talk about it a lot in sports. You know, home field advantage give you momentum, or home court advantage give you momentum.
Yeah.
But if you don't capitalize on the momentum, it can shift and work against you, because if you have a room full of employees that don't have the enthusiasm, that drains on the leader and the vision to try to keep things moving. So you have to always keep starting. So momentum, Tiff, is so important. That's a great word.
Yeah. And when you fall off on that momentum, then you find yourself kind of starting all over again.
Every time, start and start. It takes more energy to start.
Yes.
It takes more energy to start. Once I get it started, and if I keep pressure against it,
mm-hmm.
I can keep it moving. But if I let it stop, I have to exert more energy starting over again. In electronics, and I'll use this because this is my default, there's certain thing that's called capacitors. And mm-hmm. what capacitors do, their whole job is to store up energy so that when you hit the switch, it sends an instant burst of energy to that part that gets it going.
Yeah.
It don't operate the part, but it gets it going.
Mm-hmm.
And so in business, we have to have those capacitors built in, the reservoirs of power and enthusiasm that we can always infuse in there at the beginning. And we have to keep those capacitors full so that if we are in the middle, then we need to create lift that we can do that. And we see that show up in a lot of times in employee incentives and things like that to keep that momentum going and building.
Yeah, and that's such an awesome example. So then tell me, how would you create that for yourself when you're tired as the business owner, when you're still trying to figure out what everything is and you feel like slowing down and even giving up maybe? How do you maintain momentum in those moments?
Well, I think you have to stop for a moment.
Yeah.
You have to stop and refresh. A lot of time we go, and we're exerting energy and we're so running so hard trying to get there. But a lot of times you just have to stop.
Mm-hmm.
Just have to stop for a moment, refresh, reposition yourself in a way that you can start over again. Military, I'm a military guy also. So a lot of times in the military, in order for us to make the necessary assault or movement towards an objective, we call a formation.
Mm-hmm.
We bring the troops together. The bringing them together accomplished a couple of things. One, it brought, bring them to a point of unity and create that synergy. That's that word, synergy.
Energy.
We bring them together. Then we give them new orders. But while we're doing that, their bodies are able to rest and they're able to mentally rest. We have to do that for ourselves as leaders. Personally, we have to be able to take some R&R just for a moment to, so that you'll be able, you know, the priest said, well, let's take a sabbatical.
Right. And so that rest is definitely important.
I didn't say quit now.
No, don't quit. Now, okay. That's the piece, because when you're trying to gain clarity and you're trying to figure out how to start your business, you sometimes do need to take a break, so that you can recompose yourself and then start right back up again. Because when you get that clarity and that momentum and that sustainability eventually leads to your legacy.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
A couple of things we have to look at, and we have to always go back to the why.
Yeah.
Keep answering the why. Make the why so clear that it will always give you new energy. Why am I doing this? It can't be just for money.
Right.
If you're going after money, then, you know, you're going to miss it.
You know what? I totally agree with you, because when you go after money, you may make the money, but what kind of impact are you making?
Got to make impact.
Yeah.
Got to make impact.
Because it needs to be meaningful for the people that you serve. And that's what we're here for. Ultimately, we're here for service.
We're here for service. And I look at, here recently in the Houston area, and we got some other things that are going on out there now in the Gulf and Atlantic there, on the coast of Florida.
Yeah.
When we look at those things that are taking place, momentum is what's talked about when they talk about the storm. The storm has gained momentum. It's moving at an expected rate of speed. And because of that, they're able to predict the expected damage that it would cause.
Mm-hmm.
It's likewise in our business, when we have momentum and we become predictable, people know how to engage us so that we can get, you know, when I talk to Tiffany, I know what I'm going to get from speaking with Tiffany. We have to become that in business. So that momentum part is so, so critical to us as we move forward.
Absolutely. So let's talk a little bit about the strategies that you can use to gain clarity in mm-hmm. your business, because
okay.
there's so many of them, and we've kind of hit on a couple of them. But one of the top things that you can do if you're completely confused about what's going on in your business, one of the things that you need to start with is creating a list of things that you're highly skilled at and that you enjoy doing. And I recommend this because when we don't know where to start, we have to have some type of baseline. So start at, okay, what do I like to do? And how can I monetize what I like to do? Now, you mentioned something earlier about having a passion for something, but that may not necessarily be your calling.
May not be your calling.
Yeah.
I mean, I like to sing, but it needs to stay in the shower. You
right,
know?
Exactly.
You're not a recording artist. But here is, Tiffany, you hit on something. We talked about it in our previous conversation, and you talked about the S and the O of the SWOT.
Yes.
So what you just brought forth was the strength and opportunities.
Right.
So we have to be able to, one, that list that we're making, let's lay it out in a strategic form so it'll fit into our bigger picture. Let's do a SWOT analysis. So let's lay out our strength, our weaknesses, our opportunities, and our threat.
Yeah.
And so Tiffany right now, she's talking about our strength and our opportunities. Where are we able to take our strength and look at where opportunity presents itself so we can take advantage of that?
Yes. And you all see that Morris is so skilled in bringing it all back to, you know, the straight up business piece of it. So I really love the way that you use those analogies to kind of bring it home for the listeners. We're talking about clarity. Yeah. Uh-huh.
We're talking about clarity.
Yeah.
Because the one thing we don't want, if you're listening to the Business Breakfast Talk Show, we want you to be able to know that we don't have all the answers, but what we are willing to do mm-hmm. is to be vulnerable enough and exposed enough to go get the research, do the research, and bring it back to you, bring subject matter experts before you so we can talk about how do we build this relationship in business, small business, so that we all can be profitable at the end. Successful is the word we want to be.
Yes. How can we be successful? So that brings me to the second point. So we talked about creating a list of things that you're highly skilled at and turning that into a SWOT analysis. But then we also want you to consider how you like to serve others. Are you a behind the scenes person, or do you like to get your hands dirty and experience the touch and the feel of others? So when you're thinking about clarity in your business, we also want you to consider how do you want to serve? Because if you know you like to be behind the scenes, there's no reason for you to say, well, I want to get on the speaking circuit, right?
Yeah. No, I mean, if it's not your natural, now that doesn't mean you can't grow to that.
Exactly.
So we don't want to pour water on your fire.
Right.
So you can grow to that thing. Mm-hmm. But if it's not readily available to you as you're starting out, you might want to pick something that gives you an easier entrance into the marketplace.
Exactly.
So that you're not competing against yourself because of lack of skills and you're deficient in areas that you're passionate about.
Right. Absolutely. So, and that brings us into tapping into your experiences. That's another way that you can start to gain clarity in your business. So, Morris, tell us a little bit about how KLVL started. How did you use your previous experience in order to get to this point?
Well, Tiff, we talked earlier about my experience as an audio engineer and traveling and touring and doing those things like that out in the world. And I was so impressed when I came to Texas, because churches would always try to get me to do audio for them mm-hmm. in other parts of the country. And they never had money. And this is how I fed my family. I'm like,
God.
You said the Lord will, you know, the Lord, yeah, maybe he ought to encourage you to give me a paycheck, but
amen.
To be serious. So I just never thought that it would make sense for me to do it. And I got an opportunity to meet very, very large ministry here in the city. And I said, wow, they can pay you. This can be all right if I do this. And so I started working in the media here in the Houston market, working for large ministries. If I call their names, you would know all of them. Mm-hmm. But then start getting out in the community, and then we connected with a great friend and business partner, Oscar Hines, and we formed a corporation, that Genuine Journey Media, LLC. And as we continued to, we launched one radio station, the same radio station, same place and everything here at KLVL. We enjoy that now. And we just knew it was something that we wanted to present in the marketplace. Positive talk, business talk, health and wellness, community educational conversation, things that would bring people together around the breakfast table, around the dinner table, in social settings, that we can lift each other up and help share services and revenue one with another in the small business framework.
Absolutely. And so to add to that, with your engineering background, if you will, that's why if you're watching this live stream, Morris is behind the scenes now, because he's kind of multitasking for us this morning because of all of the skill that he brings to this particular show. So that leads me to a little bit about how I got into business as far as tapping into your previous experiences. Mm-hmm. And so writing has always been a thing for me.
Mm-hmm.
And in
yes.
doing that, I knew that at some point I was going to use my writing on a larger scale. And so that's kind of what led me to writing the book. And when I eventually got fed up with my job, which is probably many of you out there listening, when you get fed up with different portions of your job, you start to try to figure out how you can put those skills to even greater use. Mm-hmm. And so that's essentially what happened with me. I put that writing to use, and that has transformed over the course of even this last year. So it transitioned from writing to speaking in public places. And then it transitioned me here, so into media. So all you have to do, I guess the essential takeaway is that you just have to start. You know, if you want clarity in your business, sometimes you just got to start. You got to tap into those previous experiences and figure out how you want to put them into play. Now, one of the things you can do to tap into your experiences is you can also list out your frustrations and what you would do about them if you could. So I want to share a little story with you all. And the source is entrepreneur.com. And we want you to know that inspiration can be anywhere. And the startup story of Netflix, you all know about Netflix. So if we ever got charged for returning a video late, but didn't do anything about it, there's somebody who did. And his name was Reed Hastings. And he got a $40 late charge. And instead of getting mad, he got inspired about that.
Right.
And he wondered, well, how come movie rentals don't work like a health club where you can use it a lot or a little? And you still get charged the same thing.
Right.
Right. Right. So like some of the other major fitness facilities here, regardless of whether you come once or 50 times in a month, it's the same price.
Right.
Well, that's how Netflix came about, because he wanted to solve the problem of having to pay late fees.
Right.
And so Netflix, you know, started out as an online DVD rental service, and now it is what it is. Now we know Netflix and chill. And right. so Netflix right. has just become a household name, right? So what you want to remember is that if you're having problems finding clarity, figure out what some of the problems are in your immediate community or in your immediate space so that you can start to create solutions to those problems.
Right. You know, every problem is an opportunity for you to step up and provide a solution. What could be the avenue to your success?
Yeah.
You have to look at it different. Dr. Dwayne Dyer talks about when you change the way you look at things, the things you look at change. Mm. And so you have to be able to stop for a moment, look at what you're faced with, give it time, process it differently. And I tell you, if you change the way you look at it, the things you look at will change. We look at all the things that's around us, a lot of things that are moving all the time fast. Stop for a moment. What would you do?
Yeah, I love that. So we're going to give you an opportunity to process that piece of breakfast that you just received. And give us a call here if you have any questions about it. Join the conversations. If you're having a struggle with clarity or getting your business started, give us a call at 832-230-5592. We'll be right back.
You're listening to Synergy Radio Network. We'll be back after these messages.
KLVL, Pasadena, Houston, 1480 AM and 95.3 FM. Pearland, Sugarland, Kingwood, Katy, Acres Homes, Third Ward, The Heights, Friedmanstown, Sunnyside, Summerwood, Missouri City, Baytown, Crosby, and surrounding areas. Harvey had strength, but we have power.
Building a business is no easy task, and sometimes we need a little help along the way. If you're hungry for practical solutions to common business challenges,
grab your coffee and croissant and tune in.
Come satisfy your appetite with the Business Breakfast Talk Show. That's right, we're building and growing businesses, and this week we'll help you get clear about your vision so that you can successfully scale your empire.
Tune in at 7 a.m. to 1480 every Saturday for the Business Breakfast Talk Show, your most important meal of the day.
Attention churches and nonprofit organizations, Dawson Chemical and Janitorial Supply Company has all the chemicals and janitorial supplies you need. Toilet tissue, paper towels, trash can liners, styrofoam cups, plates, and more. They also offer churches and nonprofit organizations 10% discounts and free same-day delivery. So give us a call today at 713-697-7137. Mr. Dawson has been supplying Houston area large and small congregations for over 36 years and has three area locations to serve all of your paper, chemical, and janitorial supply needs. Dawson Chemical also sells commercial janitorial equipment, buffers, vacuum cleaners, steam cleaners, wet and dry vacs, and more. We also repair all types of janitorial equipment and provide a full line of pest control for your do-it-yourself convenience. So give us a call today at 713-697-7137 and let Dawson Chemical meet all of your paper and chemical supply needs. Again, call us at 713-697-7137. We look forward to your call. Any church that spends $100 will get a $25 gift certificate that can be used with your current purchase.
Hey, this is Tasha Evans, and I love to eat at great restaurants. And more than that, I love great desserts. So does Rashawn McDonald. check out his new website. That's www.RushonMcDonald.com. That's RushionMcDonald, and McDonald is spelled just like the famous restaurant chain. Guys, Rushon is looking for great bakers for his Baker Spotlight. He wants to brag on his fans for their incredible baking skills on his social media and website. That can be your mom, friend, coworker, or relative. Spread the word today. Visit RushonMcDonald.com.
Synergy Broadcasting, positively proud.
And we are back.
We're working.
And we are working on gaining clarity in our businesses. We're building businesses here. And one of the things that we want you all to understand is that in order for you to have clarity inside of your business, you have to have multiple pieces in order. And one of those pieces is creating your value proposition. And Morris hit on that a little bit earlier. And it's basically, what is it that you do in a short elevator pitch, if you will?
And why do I care?
Right? So when you create your value proposition, one of the things that you want to know is that first you have to introduce yourself. And then you have to say what exactly you do. So I'm going to give you an example, because we're giving you business tips here at the Business Breakfast Brunch. And one of them is how to create that value proposition. So my name is Tiffany A. Washington, and I help emerging entrepreneurs and career professionals shift from frustrated to fulfilled in their respective industries and personal lives. And then what does that do? That's my elevator pitch right there. It's just a few seconds long. And then from there, the person who you're telling that to say, well, how do you do that? So what you want to understand is when you're creating your value proposition, especially when you're trying to get clarity, you want to make sure that you hit on the highlights of your business and then allow people to ask questions based on the information that you just provided. So we want you to practice saying this and assess the reaction of others. So when you're creating that value proposition, you want to know that it's viable. So don't just create it in the dark and then not test it on anybody. You have to make sure that other people say, okay, you want to see what the reaction is.
Absolutely. You want to be able to do the beta test as much as possible.
Yes.
Because one thing that you have to know about business plans and business as a whole, it's not, your business plan is not written in stone.
Mm-hmm.
So you have to adjust it as you grow and evolve, and your client base or the demand on you grow. And you have to look and say, how do I put these demands inside of my vision and my business so that I can provide that service and that opportunity to be able to engage that potential client or sustain the client that I have and elevate the relationship, give them more opportunities to upsell, if you would, the relationship.
Right. Exactly. So after you beta test it, then you know that either you have something good to work with or you need to go back to the drawing board. That's exactly what beta testing is all about. And so the next thing you need to do is research the idea. We hit on that a little bit earlier, but what you want to know is when you're stuck, you have to go back to the research. Does the research support the business that you're trying to build? Is there room for you in the marketplace? That's a question you want to ask yourself, as well as what have others had to do to gain notoriety in the marketplace in which you're trying to penetrate? Okay, so you have to learn the pros and cons of your industry. So tell us a little bit more about that.
Well, you know, you may have a passion about something and it need to be a good hobby that may not need to be your business.
Right.
I really have some hobbies, some things I just love to do.
Yeah.
But no one's going to pay me to do them. So there's no need of me working to develop that. That's just me. That's what I love to do. That mean that need to be the business. So when you look around at what you're doing and as you develop that product, that service opportunity, you have to be realistic about what you're doing and why you're doing it. As you develop it, you have to put some skin in the game. You have to have that. You have to get it into the market to see if someone really like it before you make the full dive in. And I think you have something all in that you're going to talk about.
Yes.
Being all in is because sometimes, you know, we as business owners, we're halfway in, halfway out, and we can be persuaded to change our minds very easily.
Mm-hmm.
And I always test. If you bring something to me, If anyone ever talked to me, you bring something. First thing I'm going to do is listen to it. Then I'm going to try to convince you that it's not a good idea. That's the first thing I'm going to do. I'm going to do it very tactfully, because I'm not trying to change your mind. I just want to know if you have your mind made up.
You know what? That makes me think back on even the conversations that we've had together. And that is absolutely true. You do have to have your mind made up about what it is that is going to happen. And you have to be ready to execute that plan, regardless of what anybody says.
Absolutely.
Because you're going to have naysayers, right?
You're going to have naysayers. And so what I do as a person that's dealing with you in a relationship, I try to find out if you're strong enough emotionally to be told no. Because you're going to get some no's in business. You're going to get some people that are going to walk away from you. Bishop T.D. Jakes talked about the relationship, the constituents, the confidant, and the comrade. You have to know where to qualify and place people in your relationship when they're dealing with you. Everyone is not a confidant.
Yeah, that's good.
And you may have a constituent. They're there because you have a common agenda. A comrade because you have a common enemy or objective. But the confidant, they're there when you don't have anything. You can call them in the middle of the night and they just hold the phone and listen to you. They're there because they care about you.
Right.
And sometimes we have in our businesses people in the wrong place. And you wonder why every time you get ready to do something, you call these people together and they come together and they get your information and you see a derivative of what your private conversation was in their business ventures.
That gave me pause right there.
Yeah, you have to know that.
Yeah, and you have to know that, like you said, you have to put people in their place. And you have to know where that place is within your business.
Now, you know that coming from a sister when you said put them in their place.
Okay. And, you know, I mean it in the most professional way. Well, but, yeah, you definitely have to. You were going to say something.
Yeah, you have to make sure that you don't have people in your business in the wrong, exposed to the wrong information. Sometimes your information is sensitive, not because it's proprietary in the fact, but because you're moving in the area. And if it gets out before you launch it properly, it can have false starts in the market because people have already put up their resistance against something that you don't even know is in the marketplace that you talked about in private.
Right, absolutely. So in essence, don't throw your pearls before swine. And we're not talking about, you know, people being swine, if you will, but you just want to make sure that all of those golden nuggets that you have, you protect them, you know, because all of your business is not for everybody.
So that clarity is very necessary when you talk about protecting information that help you move your business from one phase to the next.
Yes, and you have to walk very carefully, and you have to tread lightly when you are building, when you're placing the building blocks, because what you'll end up doing is being your own worst enemy when you talk too much about certain things.
I
definitely agree with that. So we talked about researching your idea. What about the time that it takes to actually flesh out your idea? We mentioned a little bit about beta testing, and I want to talk to the audience a little bit about the power of the pause, taking a step back to reflect on your ideas.
Right.
So what does that look like and why is it so important?
I had a supervisor once in this city here, very, very strong guy that I worked for. And he would always ask me, he said, did they step back and look at it? He would always say, when they finish the task, have them stop, step back, and look at the work and inspect it. Did it measure up, one, to the assigned task, and did it exceed your expectations so that when you call me and say it's finished, is it really finished?
Is it really finished?
Did you get through?
Yeah.
Or is it finished?
That there's such a difference between the two, getting
through
and being finished.
Right.
So what you want to do is what you're saying in essence is when you take a look at it, is it something that you want to bring to the public? Is it something that you're going to be proud of? And is it something that is going to be lasting once you put it out there?
Well, as a writer, Tiffany, you talked about writing, and technical writing is a very precise thing, because you can use words to shift emotion.
Right.
And you writing from the reader's perspective. In music, and as an audio engineer, I say I'm mixing from the drummer's perspective. That means he's looking forward at the crowd. So when the snare drum hit, from the drummer's perspective, it's on the left side. But if I mix it from the audience perspective, the audience is looking at him and it's on the left side, but it's actually on their right side. So you have to know that perspective is everything in that, so you can get the clarity. Because sometimes you think you're communicating one thing in your business and you're communicating something completely different. The perception is the individual that is looking at it. It's their decision to say what they perceive.
Right, exactly.
You can be communicating it and it's not effective in your communication. Barriers to communication have things that it go through. It's cultural differences, it's all those things, it's noise, it's other things that are competing for attention. Right. That on the sender side, then the receiver has that same thing on his side or their side, her side, that when they're hearing things, they're hearing from the paradigm of their own experiences.
Right, exactly. So your perception is your reality.
Your perception is your reality.
You have to make sure that you're in tune with the people who you're trying to serve.
So a salsa or a small plate?
I think that we're giving them a, we're giving the people here today everything, and I think everybody's cup is overflowing into that salsa right now.
Yeah,
right?
But most people wouldn't, they would say a small plate depending on where you come from in the country.
That's true.
That we didn't have salsa.
Yeah.
We had small plates. When I came to the other part with the pinky in there, they said, could you pass me that salsa, that teacup salsa? I said, okay, okay. I did not look around, saw everybody else picking up the small plate. I said, oh, gotcha.
Makes sense. So your perception, yes, and where you come from. So all of those experiences help to make us who we are, and we as business owners have to be sensitive to that as we're presenting.
Let's go back, Tiffany. Let's go down to the granular level, if you would, of clarity when it comes to the business. Because the first place you have to be clear is inside the business before it's outside the business.
Yeah.
What do the people that are on your team, your employees, those that are in team work with you, what do they see, hear, and say?
Right.
Because if they're seeing, hearing, and saying something different than what you're seeing, hearing, and saying, depending on who the customer make contact with, they could get a very different product each time they meet.
Yeah, so coming into alignment and aligning all of those things. So that's taking time to flesh out your idea, the power of that pause. Now, the next thing I'm going to recommend is that you get a coach, okay? A lot of us get stuck and stay stuck because we're not talking to anybody that we can trust, and that's a professional who can actually help us through those turbulent times in our business, especially when we're trying to gain clarity. So some of the benefits of having a coach is that you'll have a sounding board, someone who's already experienced a lot of the things that you're currently going through, and they can help you to develop that clear plan. And so in life, we all have coaches, and some of those coaches are adopted, meaning we follow people and they don't know that we're following them. And they're our virtual coaches, if you will. And then we have people that we actually invest in and pay money to in order to help us to get to a certain product. What do you think about that, Morris?
You need a coach. One thing that and I'll use the sports analogy, if it would, again. When you take, for instance, a James Harden by himself is a great player. But James Harden with a good coach is a great player. Someone that can look at you and encourage you, challenge you, correct some of the things that you can't see that are so subtle because you've been doing them for so long, but they're causing you to not perform at your optimum in certain areas. You need to have that business coach to be able to come alongside you, to be able to look at the things that you do, the things that you've written down, what you say that you present to the community, and what you're actually presenting to the community, quality inspection, to be able to look at and say, nah, well, you might not want to do that. And have you ever, Tiffany, written something, came back the next day and read what you wrote and said, wait a minute, what was I trying to say again?
Oh, yeah, absolutely.
Coaches do that.
Yeah.
That's what a coach does. The coach say, I need you to shoot 1,000 free throws. And he actually has someone sitting away that you can't see, or a recorder, and you shot 850. you accomplished the same amount of time, but you did not fulfill the full prescription of what he had. He wanted to get you to a thousand because he wants you to set that level of accomplishment. I shot 1,000. I fulfilled the requirement. And so coaches are so, so necessary, Tiffany. So necessary.
Absolutely. So I think we need to take one more short break. But if you have any questions, make sure you join the conversation with us. You can either join us live stream in the comments or you can call us at 832-230-5592. It's time to work.
You're listening to Synergy Radio Network. We'll be back after these messages.
KLVL, Pasadena, Houston, 1480 AM and 95.3 FM. Pearland, Sugarland, Kingwood, Katy, Acres Homes, Third Ward, The Heights, Freedmanstown, Sunnyside, Summerwood, Missouri City, Baytown, Crosby, and surrounding areas. Harvey had strength, but we have power.
Hey, this is Tasha Evans, and I love to eat at great restaurants. And more than that, I love great desserts. So does Rashawn McDonald. Check out his new website. That's www.rashawnmcdonald.com. That's R-U-S-H-I-O-N, and McDonald is spelled just like the famous restaurant chain. Guys, Rashawn is looking for great bakers for his Baker's Spotlight. He wants to brag on his fans for their incredible baking skills on his social media and website. That can be your mom, friend, coworker, or relative. Spread the word today. Visit RashawnMcDonald.com.
Hey, hey now, this is Amber Shaw inviting you to join me Sunday afternoons for Unplugged Praise. You'll get a dose of industry news, artist interviews, and music from some of your favorite artists such as John P. Key, Pastor Shirley Caesar, Marvin Sapp, and I can't forget about my Houston Gospel fam, Angela Bennett, Chad Brawley, Kathy Taylor, Wallace Grant II, and the list goes on and on. So tell your family, friends, and all your church members, Unplugged Praise is your kind of praise.
Unplugged Praise with Amber Shaw, Sundays 1 to 4 p.m. here on 1480 KLVL.
And now, back to the...
We are working over here this morning with the Business Breakfast Talk Show, and we've been talking about how to gain more clarity in your business. So now that we've given you the tips and tools that you need to gain more clarity, it's time to go all in. So that means that you need to take the information we spoke about today and take massive action. So Walt Disney says that the way to get started is to quit talking and start doing. So I want you all to understand that it's time out for talking. What are you going to put into action now? Quick story for you. Sarah Blakely of Spanx. Now, my women out there who are listening, you all know what Spanx are. Those are the things that keep us tight and right under our clothes, right? So Sarah Blakely, for those of you who don't know the story, she didn't quit. She decided that she wanted some undergarments that were going to give us clean lines under our clothes. Mm-hmm. And she wanted to make them footless, if you will. So instead of just wearing support that was going to go all the way down to our toes, she cut the ankles off. And she decided that that was going to help us to look better in our wardrobe. So she took this idea all the way to Neiman Marcus. She had that idea and she ran with it. The Neiman Marcus representative, the buyer, decided that these were some of the best things ever. And she purchased thousands of them. And that was the start of Sarah Blakely's business with Spanx. And of course, they've gone on to sell millions and they've expanded into all types of undergarments. And you know, they even have Spanx for men now. So if you didn't know that, you should actually check
them out. I don't
think
I'm going to be wearing that one, but okay.
But you know, some men might feel like they need to get it tight in some areas. So I'm not going to knock the men who might want to try that, because clearly she felt like there was a marketplace for that.
Oh, absolutely. Well, I've seen them with dresses on. So, you know, yeah. And not kilts either.
Yeah. there you go. So we want to make sure that you understand that you have to see the vision and you have to see the vision through. Because Sarah got many no's before she got her yes. And even when she got that yes, she had to take that purchaser into the bathroom to try her product on before that yes came. So right. You have to be persistent in what it is that you're trying to do. And that was her taking massive action. So I hope that story serves you well. You also have to garner additional professional development on how to exercise your skills in business. So as Morris said earlier, become a YouTube University student.
Absolutely.
And do everything that you need to.
Now, on the YouTube University, they're just like in college, educational system, there's good teachers and there not so good teachers.
Great point.
So you have to make sure that you look at the individual that you're getting information from and then do your own homework about it.
Yeah.
Don't just take that one YouTube university professor.
Right, exactly. So for some final thoughts, just to sum all of this up for you, what you need to remember is that you have to trust your instincts. You have to make sure that you enjoy your journey inside of business and on your way to building this great business. And don't take direction from people who are not familiar with your vision. That's one of the things that I've learned personally as I've been growing. Everybody's not going to hold your vision the same way because the vision was given to you. So you have to guard it, protect it, and execute it.
Then the other thing, if you're going to solicit someone, a professional advice, and they take the time to meet with, don't waste their time.
Right.
Don't waste their time. If they take time to share with you some insight, listen to what you have to say, don't waste their time, because that's the worst thing you can do is to start a relationship where people are taking time talking with you, hearing what it is that you want to accomplish, and then, you know, you're sitting there, you're in a whole nother world, you walk away from them, take none of the advice that they give you, and then don't take advice from people that haven't accomplished anything.
Oh, amen.
You got a lot of people sitting there like Monday morning quarterbacks, and they're sitting there, but they're not in business. They're not doing anything, but they can tell you every mistake that you made. Now, listen to the information, because even in the from a fool's advice, you can learn something.
Absolutely.
You know.
Yeah, absolutely. So those are our thoughts for the Business Breakfast Talk Show. We hope you enjoyed your breakfast this morning, and we hope you're fueled and have the energy you need to build and grow your empire this week. We'll be back next week at 7 a.m. same time. Remember to bring a friend. We're preparing breakfast, and we're going to give you the menu that you desire.
Tiffany, how can they get in contact with you? They have a subject, a topic that they want to talk about next week or the weeks in the coming in the future. How can they get kind of contact with
you? So with me personally, you can contact me on my business page at Transformation 7. So if you go to Facebook, you can find me at T7 by Tiffany, the letter T, the number 7 by Tiffany, and post your questions there. And I'll grab those questions and we'll make sure, Morris and I will make sure that those questions get answered. And if you want to, I'm also open on my website, www.transformation7.com. So shoot me a message, find me on LinkedIn, and let's get to work.
Absolutely. It is the Business Breakfast Talk Show. I've finished my croissant, my coffee. I'm going to warm it up a little bit more because I still have yet a little to do before I move into our lunchtime, but it has been a pleasure, Tiffany, to be here with you this morning. I'm looking forward to next week. We had clarity this week. On the first week, we talked about developing the business and laying out the agenda. I think we're getting ready to build a business plan.
We're getting ready to build a business plan. Okay. And so we want you to take that journey with us.
All right. Thank you so much. You've been listening to the Business Breakfast Talk Show with Tiffany Washington and Morris Parsons. We'll see you next week.
Crisis. I believed all of your dreams are duration. You took my heart, all my keys, and my patience. You took my heart, all my sleep, a decoration. You mistaken my love, I brought for you for foundation.
Synergy Network Radio, where it all comes together.
Attention churches and nonprofit organizations, Dawson Chemical and Janitorial Supply Company has all the chemicals and janitorial supplies you need. Toilet tissue, paper towels, trash can liners, styrofoam cups, plates, and more. They also offer churches and nonprofit organizations 10% discounts and free same-day delivery. So give us a call today at 713-697-7137. Mr. Dawson has been supplying Houston area large and small congregations for over 36 years and has three area locations to serve all of your paper, chemical, and janitorial supply needs. Dawson Chemical also sells commercial janitorial equipment, buffers, vacuum cleaners, steam cleaners, wet and dry vacs, and more. We also repair all types of janitorial equipment and provide a full line of pest control for your do-it-yourself convenience. So give us a call today at 713-697-7137 and let Dawson Chemical meet all of your paper and chemical supply needs. Again, call us at 713-697-7137. We look forward to your call. Any church that spends $100 will get a $25 gift certificate that can be used with your current purchase.
Did you know that Shirley Ann's Black Collectibles and Flowers has one of the largest displays of black statues in the country? They're located in the heart of Acres Home. Shirley Ann's has a special treasure to add to your collection, and it's the perfect place to find the ideal gift for someone you love. They also take care of all of your floral needs. Shirley Ann's Black Collectibles, 6130 Wheatley Street. Call 713-692-1100. That's 713-692-1100. Shirley Ann's Black Collectibles.
Hi. Hello. Hello. This is Rashawn McDonald. I'm back. This Monday, Money Making Conversation returns 11 a.m. Please listen, because guess what? I want you to call me too, 832-230-5592. I've been down, the weather had me down, but guess what? My spirits are up, and I want to get your spirits up and recognize that you too should be successful. So listen to Money Making Conversation. I have my boy back live on the show, Anthony Hamilton, and many other small businesses that will allow you to see that you can be successful too. Listen to Money Making Conversations this Monday at 11 a.m.
Money Making Conversations with Rashawn McDonald this Monday, 11 a.m. to 1 p.m. here on 1480 KLPL. AM KLVL, Pasadena, Houston, and 95.3 FM KT37GSQ, Pasadena.
Hi, hello, hello, this is Rashawn McDonald. I'm back. This Monday, Money Making Conversation returns 11 a.m. Please listen, because guess what? I want you to call me too, 832-230-5592. I've been down, the weather had me down, but guess what? My spirits are up, and I want to get your spirits up and recognize that you too should be successful. So listen to Money Making Conversation. I have my boy back live on the show, Anthony Hamilton, and many other small businesses that will allow you to see that you can be successful too. Listen to Money Making Conversations this Monday at 11 a.m.
Money Making Conversations with Rashawn McDonald this Monday, 11 a.m. to 1 p.m. here on 1480 KLPL.
You are waking up to the Be Incredibly Well Morning Show. It's time to step out of your comfort zone. Time for you to get unstuck and take responsibility for your life. We bring you hope. We provide you with solutions on how to move forward in life. Just to make it plain, I'm here to shake you up, guys. Strengthen your confidence to help you do, be, and give more. The Be Incredibly Well Morning Show focuses on every aspect of you. Why? Three words. Because you matter. I am Tasha Evans, empowerment speaker, author, and life coach. Your journey toward becoming incredibly well starts now.
Always exciting. Good morning, guys. We want to thank you so much for waking up with us. Always a pleasure to connect with you. Thank you for tuning into the Be Incredibly Well Morning Show. I am your host, Tasha Evans. So excited, live in the studio with us this today, my good friend, my BFF, my big bro, also my favorite co-host, NFL great Tyrone Smith. Hi, you all right?
Man, I'm living the dream, man. I'm grateful yet thankful and humble at the same time.
Love it. And our featured guest today, so grateful. This awesome, awesome man of God. Pleasure to meet you, Mr. Bo Porter, special assistant to the general manager of the Atlanta Braves. So, Bo, how are you?
I'm doing outstanding.
Are you?
I'm in great company, and I'm honored to be here. How was your drive over?
My drive over was pretty good. Oh. I hopped on the Beltway. Uh-huh. My navigation was trying to take me a different way, but I just figured if I stay on the Beltway, I'll get there because it's one big loop, mm-hmm. and I end up coming the right direction.
Oh, that's good.
Yes.
Let me tell you something about Saturday mornings for some reason. I've run into traffic before 7 a.m., and I'm not sure why. Okay. So, tie two, last week, you can feel my pain on that tie.
Yes, I can feel your pain. We're not going to talk about it because I was driving on the shoulder.
Yeah, we're not going to tell them that you drove on the shoulder side. We're not going to do that. But if anybody who's in the Houston area, if you all have to do is say 290, and I just drop the mic right there because everybody understands.
290's been under construction for like, what, 10 years?
Right.
Yes. Maybe 20. So,
well, I've been in Houston for 20 years, so it could be 20 years.
Right.
Guys, I mean, thank you so much. Thank you both for being here. I appreciate it. I appreciate your commitment to help me spread the word of well-being. And so I appreciate you guys. I'm excited about our show today. A quick special shout out to guys. If you're listening live in your car, if you're watching us live on Facebook, we want to thank you guys, as always, for waking up with us. We appreciate your love and your support. We want to hear from you this morning, too. So 832-230-5592, 832-230-5592. If you're on Facebook, we want to hear your comments. We want to hear your questions. Anything you have for Mr. Beauporter today, any questions you have for Ty or myself, we're here for you today, guys. We're very much committed to the message of well-being. And before I want, just quickly, I want to do a special thank you to A to Z Real Estate and Beyond Eye Care for powering up our show today, guys. We appreciate your support with helping us to spread the message of well-being. God has really given me a charge to promote the message of well-being. And within that, we hit every aspect of well-being, Mr. Bo. We go mental health. We go emotional. We talk to people about, give them hope and encouragement. Why aren't you sleeping at night? What's going on in your life? You know, why? Whatever's happened in your life that may have derailed you, that may have you stuck. So many people are living unfulfilled lives. So we provide that level of encouragement and inspiration to empower individuals to move forward. So,
Well, you're speaking my language. When you start when you start talking about empowerment and whole person development, you are speaking my language.
Oh, that's just my heart. So where did it start for you? What's that thing for you?
You know, I think, you know, when I look at my background, obviously I have a huge background in sports, but I think coming from the inner city where, you know, I witnessed a lot of the downtrends of development, and then going to the University of Iowa where I was surrounded by, you know, Hayden Fry and his whole coaching staff, which were completely entrenched in their relationship with Christ, which allowed me to develop a strong faith in the relationship in Christ while I was there. And as I fast forward to my playing career, my mm-hmm. coaching career, mm-hmm. I just found myself in that space where I always wanted to see where there are avenues in which I can help other people.
Yes.
And when you start to talk about wellness and helping people, it's almost, you know, the theory of, you know, you can feed a man, you know, a fish, but if you teach them how to fish, you do something that will last a lifetime.
I love that because we're going to always have challenges.
Yes.
So you're right. When you talk about the opportunity to train and to teach people to how to overcome, you know, how to just deal with the challenges. And I know sometimes, if times people look at our lives, they may think that, you know, our lives are perfect because we may be, we're doing this and we may be, you know, doing different things within radio, but okay, guys. So, gotta do this. Also, hey, tag, share. Thank you guys so much back here. But very much important, you know, for us to be focused on who we are, how to move forward, our overall well-being, because our decisions, they affect us. Next thing you know, it impacts our children and our community. So that's why we're here, guys, to bring you hope, to provide you with solutions on how to move forward. So I'm gonna volley this over to Ty, I want you to, you know, please introduce our guest, talk about, you know, all the awesome things he has going on, and guys, get ready. It's so many things.
Bo has so much to offer, man, as an individual. He's a man of God. He's an author. He's a Major League Baseball executive. He's an advocate of change. I mean, and Bo, there's a lot that's actually going on with you, man. If there was a couple of things in particular that you would like to share with the audience, what would be like, you know, one of the things or a couple of things, because you actually have a lot going on, man. I really appreciate you for who you are and all that you do and offer as a person.
Well, thank you, Ty. I really appreciate that. I think, you know, for the most part, it's one, it's about sharing your blessings. And as I sit here today, I know that I am extremely blessed. God has put some wonderful people into my life. He has provided some wonderful mentors. And every opportunity that I get and where I can share those blessings, I try to find avenues to do so, whether it's in our nonprofit organization, which is the Stacy and Bo Porter Self Foundation, where we mentor and we have the after-school programs for over 4,000 underprivileged, underserved children in HISD.
Wow, 4,000.
Yes, and it has grown. And you look at, you know, we started this 4 years ago, and our first class of kids, which are now sophomores in high school, we've started the pilot program at Key Middle School, and it was with 36 kids. And Key Middle School actually was one of the schools that HISD had on this list of schools to close.
Wow.
They had lost their magnet program. They were going to close the school. We actually come in with the Self Foundation program, you know, ministering to the kids. And our after-school program, we then started a before-school program called Boys to Men and Ladies and Leaders of the Future, where our male teachers meet with the young men, our female teachers meet with the young ladies every morning. And it's more so just giving them positive influence. And you fast forward 4 years, Key Middle School, not only have they gotten their magnet program back, they actually had the largest decrease in out-of-school suspension days of any school in HISD.
Wow.
So they went from like 1,300 to a minus 600 in suspension days. So you go from having a hard time just keeping the kids in school to now they actually have the best overall, you know, decrease in suspension days. And you look at that first group of kids that came through our program, 36 of them, they're now in the top 5% in GPA in their sophomore class.
Oh, my goodness.
Wow. So when you're talking about full circle and, you know, just trying to give back to the community, I look at my life and I know how it evolved, and at some point within the show, we'll probably talk about my upbringing and how I actually ended up going to play baseball in the first place. Mm-hmm. It actually started with a kind gesture from a community friend. So, I mean, philanthropic endeavors, business endeavors have always been a part of my thought process, but at the center of it all and at the core of it all, it's about helping people.
Yes, yes. Wow. So much with that. So much with that. We're going to get into the details of SELF, and I want to make sure we highlight that. So SELF is sports, education, life skills, and faith.
And again, it goes back to the whole person.
Yes.
And that's why I said you are definitely speaking my language. When you look at, you know, the development of youth, if you're able to provide sports, which is physical activity.
Yes.
Right. If you put a focus on education, education is the ultimate game changer.
Mm-hmm.
Right.
And then when you look at life skills, those are all the things that are not going to be a part of the regular school curriculum.
Mm-hmm.
Because the regular school curriculum is more based on someone in the educational field sitting down and saying, by the time you graduate from middle school, you should have learned these things. Well, we all know that there are life issues that you're not going to find in a textbook.
Right.
So we as an organization or a foundation, we try to present a lot of those real life issues to our kids. We just had a partnership that I have been working on for 2 years.
Mm-hmm.
Wells Fargo is a proud sponsor of the Self Foundation Financial Literacy Program. So in all of the schools where the Self Foundation program is taking place, we're going to start to have a weekly edition where Wells Fargo is going to come in and they are basically going to administer a financial literacy program to the kids in our program.
And what age group are we talking?
This is all middle school, 6th, 7th, and 8th grade.
Okay.
And we want to get them early. And then on the weekends, once a month, we're going to have the same financial literacy program that will administer to the parents on the weekends in our schools on Saturdays.
That is phenomenal. Ty, you go. I know you're about
to jump in. Let's read some of the things. Man, on February 2nd, 2017, the Stacy and Bo Porter Self Foundation was honored by Mayor Turner that from February the 2nd, 2017 and forward, February 2nd is now proclaimed the Self Foundation Day in Houston. Man, that's awesome.
Congratulations.
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 Thank you. Well, I mean, one, we want to thank the mayor. We want to thank, you know, the whole council, councilmen and councilwomen in Houston for that type of recognition. And, I mean, I would be remiss if I didn't, you know, sit here and thank our board of directors, thank our honorary chair, Mr. Robert Duncan, thank all of our advisory council, thank, you know, HISD for their wonderful partnership. Because without all of those integral parts working together,
absolutely,
the Self Foundation would not be able to have the impact in which we're able to have. Mm-hmm. And at the end of the day, you know, it's about the children. And I think that's one of the things in which I credit our foundation with, I credit our board with. We really focus on the children. Mm-hmm. We focus on how can we impact the children. Every decision in which we make as a board and as a foundation, the focal point is always, how is this going to impact the kids?
What kind of feedback are you hearing from your kids? You know,
the feedback is phenomenal. And I'll go straight to, we get a research report from HISD every year. Mm-hmm. It's called an accountability report.
Yes.
And within that accountability report, HISD sends out teachers that interview our kids. And they interview the kids and they talk to the kids about the program, about their likes, about their dislikes. Mm-hmm. We also have a essay competition. This is another component of our foundation that I think really just escalated our entire foundation. Michelle Burrell, who is an Olympic gold medalist, yes. She is our program director. And she implemented this essay competition at all of our schools. And it started out where we implemented the essay competition. At first, it was not being done in conjunction with the English curriculum. Mm-hmm. And some of the students, you know, they submitted essays. Other students just decided not to do it. Mm-hmm. Well, we also have assemblies, which, Ty, I'm going to get you on the docket. Man, to come and be one of the speakers at the assembly.
I'm ready.
Yes. Yeah, so we have these assemblies where we have speakers come in and talk about the topic of the essay for that month. So the essay topic could be, you know, the importance of, you know, education.
Yes.
So each student in the school, you can submit an essay because the winning essays get $50 a piece. So when we had the first assembly and the kids see the kids come on the stage and win the $50, they were like, oh, I didn't know you get $50 if you win. Right. I would have won an essay too.
Sign me up too.
Yes. So obviously the number of essays went from, you know, 50 or 60 essays to 600.
Wow.
So
incentive.
So with the essays, we also put in a component where each student have to get 3 letters of recommendation from faculty within the building to their English grade. So it's just come full circle, and we look at some of those essays when these kids were in sixth grade, and you talk about a maturation. If you watch someone write in the sixth grade, and then you listen and you read what they write in the eighth grade, it really show you how they have evolved.
Man.
Oh, my goodness. You know what? I'm going to have to, guys, we have to take a quick break. I'm so excited. We're live here with NFL great Tyrone Smith, as well as Bo Porter, special assistant to the general manager of Atlanta Braves. Guys, any questions, comments with regards to our conversation, we want to hear from you. Facebook, thank you for your comments and your feedback. We will respond today, 832-230-5592. We'll keep it locked. We'll be right back. Every time I hear it, it's like the first time. Guys, thank you so much. We appreciate you staying connected with us. If you are just now joining, you are tuned into the Be Incredibly Well Morning Show. So, so encouraged. Live here with Tyrone Smith and Mr. Bo Porter. Great show, guys. Today we're talking about perseverance, patience, and purpose, perseverance, and patience. And so it's just an opportunity to connect with Mr. Bo, and he just an incredible career. All-star basketball, football, baseball, Houston Astros, former head coach. I mean, he has done it all. And we're promoting the message of well-being within this platform. I love it because we share the same, actually all of us. Ty has passion for personal development, and so does Bo. We're all big on leadership. We're all speakers. We're all authors, you know, so we're all very much committed to making a difference in your life by promoting the message of well-being. And people often ask, you know, Tasha, why the message of well-being? And I say 3 words: because you matter. Because you matter. Every aspect of you matters. What's going on in your finances matters. What's going on in your personal relationships? What's going on in your mental state? You know, what's going on with your children? Every aspect of you matters. And so that's what we do within this platform. We bring you hope. We provide you with solutions on how to move forward. And so, with that, I didn't get a chance to ask you about your
how you support your personal well-being. We didn't talk about that earlier.
I think, one, you have to make sure that you are fostering an intimate relationship with Christ.
Yes.
And when I say fostering an intimate relationship with Christ, that's not a relationship where you are sharing in God's word with other people. Even though I think fellowship is very important, I think you need to spend one-on-one time with Christ. Mm-hmm. And we have a prayer room in our house, and it's a place where I wake up, I work out, I get into the prayer room, and it just gets my day started in the right way. In the morning, once I leave for spring training and I break and I'm on the road, I started a book club a long time ago where I would send out messages to over 700 some odd people. The messages would go out 5:30 every morning, and I would get text messages from friends like, okay, can you send this at like 10 or can you send it at like 11? And, you know, my comment to them was, you know, I want to share it as soon as, you know, the feeling hit me and I'm sharing in the mood of feeling God's word. But I think when you start to think about purpose, you ask yourself this question: who do you spend the most time with? You spend the most time with yourself.
Right.
Wow.
So when you focus on making you a better you,
wow,
it allows you to actually be an extension to help someone else. You cannot help someone else, mm-hmm, if you can't help yourself.
That's good. We're going to hashtag that, focus on you today.
Hashtag focus on you.
I love that because it brings us back to the reality that you matter.
Yes, absolutely.
So, and it's so, unfortunately, it's easy to get caught up in the busyness of life to where we are not a priority, mm-hmm, unfortunately. So you're right, bringing that to the forefront is key.
It's very important. I think a lot of times you look at, you know, obstacles, and you guys, you know, we talk about perseverance as well, and I don't want to get ahead of the show, but I love the three P's in which you guys have mapped out, mm-hmm, because I think that, again, you go back to whole person development. And if you don't have a purpose, and if you don't have perseverance, and if you're not going to be patient, we're living in a world where it's almost like the microwave world. Everybody wants exactly what they want. They want it right now.
Absolutely.
And it's not meant to be that way. There are trials. There are, you know, obstacles in which we all have endured. We all have to overcome. And I'm a firm believer that your obstacles and in the things in which you endure, they actually help mold you into the person in which God meant for you to be.
Mm-hmm. Life happens for us.
Yes, absolutely.
Mm-hmm.
So we're designed for a reason. So with that being said, as you think about purpose, Bo, like, man, what is like your story in regards to like your journey from that kid growing up in like Brick City? Like, what's your story?
You know, I think when I think about purpose, I think it's when you find your purpose is when I really think you really start to live. I think, you know, when
say that again.
I think when you find your purpose is right, when you really start to live. And I mean, I talk about this in both of my books. It's when I look at my life and I look at coming from Brick City, and for many of you that have never been to Newark, New Jersey, especially during, you know, the 70s, the 80s, and the 90s, it's a pretty rough place. Mm-hmm. I mean, at any moment, gunshots can fire out, and, you know, armed robbery, you know, from drug pushing to drug using to, you know, gang violence, you name it. I was born and raised in the center of it all. So my community did a great job. My family did a tremendous job. And I'm a firm believer that ships don't sink
right,
because of the water around them. Hmm. Ships sink because of the water that get in them. So you can be raised in an atmosphere where your circumstances all around you, you know, they may not be conducive to living the life in which you would want to lead. But mm-hmm, if you don't allow all of that to get in you, then you actually are
that
starting
is so
your
good
purpose.
Wow.
So when I look at where I came from, I look at where God has delivered me today and the platform in which he has allowed me, you know, to share in his kingdom. I say to myself, one, he didn't have to pick me.
Right.
So because he picked me, it just gives me such a purpose to live in that kingdom and do everything that I can to share those blessings to edify other people.
I'm glad you said that because it's such a That says a lot. And I want to encourage whoever is listening and who's watching us live, you're chosen as well. And that's a blessing to understand that. And it takes your spirit, takes your emotional state and your mental state to another place when you understand that we've been chosen by God for, and we all have an assignment. And I know people often think, well, I don't have a purpose, and maybe I don't sing, and I don't dance, and I don't know how to write a book, and, you know, so what's that thing for me?
Can
you know?
I say something?
Please,
can I
please.
Say something? And I mean this in all sincerity. If your purpose is to impact one person, you should impact that one person. And if you don't, then you're not exercising your purpose.
Wow.
Because God give all of us different assignments.
Right.
Mm-hmm. My purpose could be 1 million people. Your purpose can be 5 million people. Your purpose can be 200 people.
Right.
The next person's purpose may be 2 people.
Right.
So as you're looking to find your purpose, find out what is God trying to get you to do. And it may be in the space that you're in. It may be that he's wanting to expand your territory, but he wants you to work on you first mm-hmm. before he expand your territory. So it goes back to, one, the person you spend the most time with is yourself.
Right.
So you have to get right within yourself.
Right.
And then find out, what is your purpose? Where is he trying to lead me? Is he trying to expand my territory? Have I conquered the territory that he have me in right now?
Right.
Because we all know that God's not going to move forward unless you conquer the task he have in front of you.
Right.
Yes.
Ty and I both about to just be like, man, so much here. I love that because so many people think that their purpose is that moment of them on the stage with 1 million people in front of them speaking. But I love what you said. Just be grateful for the opportunity to touch one.
Right.
What Absolutely. An impact that makes, because sometimes we forget touching that one, and that person will the, what you shared with them, they will go and touch other people.
That's called a legacy. And that's, and again, as we all walk this earth and we all try to figure out our purpose, your purpose may be, Tyrone's purpose may be to touch me. But realistically, God know that by him touching me, I'm going to go touch 2 more people.
Right.
That he probably meant for Tyrone to touch. But he said, you know what, Tyrone? Bo going to have more access to those people. So I'm going to make sure you touch Bo and make sure now Bo go touch the people that were meant for you to touch. Mm-hmm. So again, it's all coming full circle.
Wow. I mean, and that even speaks to, just hearing you talk about it, boy, that speaks to just like the core men and the core women. I mean, talk a little bit about that. I mean, as far as just like connecting and touching and you just expanding your reach through others.
Exactly. And the core of men, for many people that don't know, the core of men and the core of women is a division of my company, Real Excellence, Inc. And CORE is an acronym for Champions of Real Excellence. Mm-hmm. And we have 4 core principles. It's about being transformational leaders in 4 areas of your life. Christ, family, career, and legacy. And again, back to our punchline, whole person development.
Yes.
Christ, family, career, legacy. But the core was more so developed because I realized the impact of surrounding yourself with like-minded people.
Yes.
And when you look at the people in which you share space with, okay, if you're not surrounding yourself with people that are edifying and uplifting you, your life is not stagnant. You're not just going to stay in one place. It's either you're growing or you're digressing. You're digressing. So if you're not going to surround yourself with people that are going to help you grow.
Absolutely.
You're basically putting yourself in a position where you're going to start to regress as a person. So when I put the core together, it was, how can I, one, find a chartered group of members? And these are members that I know that we're going to be able to, one, bring together a mission that will allow us to take business marketing, mm-hmm. take networking, take philanthropy, take mentorship to another whole level, where not only are we impacting each other, but we're impacting our community, our family, and our legacy.
Powerful.
Guys. Very much powerful. We're going to take a quick break. You know, questions, 832-230-5592, 832-230-5592. If you are with us live on Facebook, thank you so much for your comments, for your questions. You know, let me see. Golly, everybody's shouting you out, Bo. I'm telling you.
Somebody said preach, Bo.
So keep them coming, guys. We appreciate you, your comments, your feedback. Again, questions, 832-230-5592. Come back with us. We're continuing our discussion with Mr. Bo Porter on purpose, perseverance, and patience.
Memories and more. Better than ever before.
Better than ever before.
With a different show every day.
Monday.
We go back in the day with all of your old school favorites on a more memory Monday.
Tuesday.
It's going to be a party.
It's Two-Steppin' Tuesday. It's Two-Steppin' Tuesday with Zydeco. Country and Western, Southern Soul, and Blues.
Wednesday.
It's a wide open Wednesday. That's the day we have a little bit of everything, including you, to talk about all the things we do.
Thursday.
Thursdays are always special with many specialty shows.
Friday.
It's the Friday Showdowns when your favorite artists battle it out and you determine the winner.
Memories and more.
Memories and more.
Better than ever before.
Better than ever before. Coming soon to 1480.
Welcome back, guys. Thank you so much. You are tuned into the Be Incredibly Well Morning Show. I am Tasha Evans. We're live here with NFL great Tyrone Smith and the special assistant to the general manager of the Atlanta Braves, Mr. Bo Porter. Guys, powerful discussion today on well-being, on purpose, on perseverance, on patience. We are very much committed to making a difference in your life, very much committed to providing you with solutions on how to move forward. So, before the break, if you missed it, number one, if you're on Facebook, you want to catch the live feed or catch the replay. Bo has hit some powerful, powerful nuggets on with regards to purpose and how to connect with it. And one thing that I appreciate you said is connecting with yourself. So what you said? How'd you say that? Spend the most time with yourself. Yes. And I love this one. He said, I had to write this one down. It says the ship does not sink because of the water around it.
No.
The ship sinks because of the water that goes within.
Yes.
Let me say that again. The ship does not sink as a result of the water around it.
It can go all the way to the shore. It can go out as far as you want it to go, stand on water. But when that water get in, you got trouble.
Wow. Powerful, powerful, powerful. We're very much committed to, yes, your overall well-being. All of our guests, all of our programming, all of our campaigns, conferences, we designed with you in mind because you matter. And so if questions, comments, we want to hear from you, 832-230-5592, 832-230-5592. You want to help us share. You want to help us tag this message on well-being, on purpose, on perseverance, on patience, just to continue to, you know, propel this message throughout social media to other individuals who may be lost, hurt, or broken, who may not understand that they are chosen, that they are important, that they matter. So with that said, we're going to keep it going. So yeah. We talked a little bit about purpose. Let's talk about perseverance.
Let's talk about perseverance. And so when I think about perseverance, bro, I think about just, you know, my life and about the journey. You know, we have to persevere and go through so much because I remember just, you know, people telling me in regards to playing the game of football that I would never make it. You know, you're too small, Tyrone. You're too skinny. You got a big head. You cry all the time. You're not good enough. You're not big enough. You're not fast enough. You're not cute enough. So I had to persevere despite the fact that people told me I couldn't accomplish it or despite the fact that people told me that I couldn't be it. So in it, it's about like embracing the journey. So mm-hmm. when you think about your life and the journey, I mean, what does perseverance mean to you and how does it actually apply to your journey in general as well?
Well, one, I think you are what you think you are. And I think a lot of times people that may say that to you, it's almost like they're putting their own shortcomings or stipulations onto you. And I'm the same way. I had to persevere. I was a three-sport athlete. And because I played three sports, I actually missed a lot of valuable time baseball-wise. Because I was busy playing football and then I was busy playing basketball. So when I got drafted in baseball after my junior year at Iowa and I signed to go play, but I still committed to coming back to play my senior year of football. So even in my first year playing, you know, only played like 45 games. Whereas the guys in which I'm playing against, they're playing 180, 200 games a year. So I was way behind. So just like you, I had many people coming to me saying, you should have stuck with football. Baseball is not going to work. You missed too much time. You this, you that, you that.
Wow.
And, you know, I'm a firm believer that obstacles that are put in front of you, they're put in front of you because of what it is you're going to become. I think a lot of times people look at their obstacles
wow.
that they're going through and they think that, you know, this is just not for me. Well, no.
Right.
If you have the perseverance to fight through it, that's God's message to you that it is for you. When people talk about quitting, I think that for me, it's something that happened long ago. I was 7 years old, and we were playing baseball in my community. We used to play in the church parking lot. And there was a call that didn't go my way. Mm-hmm. I got mad about it, you know, grabbed my bat, grabbed my glove, and I run to the house. I'm not playing with these guys anymore. So my mom come outside, and she's like, I thought you were playing with the guys in the parking lot. I said, I don't want to play with them. They cheat. You know, it's a bad call, this and that. She said, so you quit. And I said, no, I just got mad. She said, no, you quit. She said, let me tell you something. The only thing quitting is going to do is that you will never find out whether or not you were good enough.
Wow. Hmm.
So my message on perseverance is simply this. Whatever you believe in your heart of heart that you're designed to do, you're better off going 100% and getting the result in which God has determined will be your end result and deal with that result rather than not giving 100% and stopping and not finding out whether or not you were good enough.
That's good stuff.
That is so good. So many people, you do just that, they stop.
They stop. Well, they stop because they believe that they have the answer. They take their own thought process and go, well, this is not meant to be. Like, if you would have taken with whoever the people that were telling you, you're too slow, you're too this, you're too skinny, and you took that as fact, then you would just stop because you would go, well, they're telling me the truth.
Mm-hmm. Right.
But perseverance is what made you keep going. You didn't believe what they were telling you because you felt like God had another calling for you.
Got it.
That kept you going. So again, I'm going to go back to the premise of this. Tap into yourself.
Yes.
Don't let other people tell you what you can't and what you cannot do. Tap into yourself, and then your perseverance will come to the forefront.
Hashtag tap into yourself. Say that again. Hashtag tap into yourself, because you think about it. How many people, because I'll be transparent, I have believed what maybe a teacher said or what a friend said or what a family member said about me and believed it.
Yes.
And that became my reality. But you're right, connecting with who I am in Christ and what God has for me. So regardless of what you think or whether you think the Be Incredible Well morning show or this platform will work, it doesn't matter what you think.
It doesn't. Have you ever set out to do something that a lot of people told you wasn't going to happen or that you couldn't do?
Right.
And all of a sudden, as you continue in your journey, God just starts to remove obstacles. I remember when I first realized I wanted to be a major league manager.
Right.
And there were guys that I played with, guys in which I played against. I mean, one, they looked at me, they said, Bo, I mean, one is only 30 of those jobs. It's probably not going to happen. You know, I mean, it's a great goal, but it's probably not going to happen. Well, by the age of 40, I was the youngest manager in Major League Baseball.
Wow.
And if I would have taken what they said to me as fact and as face value, I would not have prepared the way I prepared so that when I was blessed with that opportunity, mm-hmm. that I would be ready for the opportunity. So again, when you look at perseverance, it is a lot of it has to do with just your inner strength,
right.
and how much you can fight through the obstacles that are laid in front of you, knowing that at the end of the day, if it's meant to be and it's God's will, he will remove all obstacles.
You know, love it. Guys, we have a caller. Let's bring him in. It's Ahmad. Yes. Good morning.
Good morning, Tasha, Tyrone, Be Incredibly Well. Also, your man, Bo, brother Bo, who's on the line as well.
Oh, I'm sorry, Ahmad. Can you repeat that? Can you hear okay, Bo?
I can't hear.
We got to turn the volume. Is the volume up? All right.
Hey, good morning, Ahmad. Thank you so much for tuning into the Be Incredible Well morning show. Thank you for calling in.
Good morning, Tasha.
Good morning.
Brother Tyrone over there as well, my colleague. And your brother Bo Porter today, I had a couple of points I wanted to make this morning because Bo just decided to spark a couple of nerves in me this morning.
Uh-oh.
Okay.
I just I heard when you were talking about expanding your territory, and you know, trying to take things to the next level. And you was like, you know, things have to come in a certain progression. And I always say that, you know, a lot of people want, you know, Tasha mentioned about having being on a big stage in front of millions of people.
Mm-hmm.
Well, if there's three or four people in front of you, if you're not willing to impact them and help them do more, then we got a problem there. See, the problem is a lot of people don't want to do that word called service.
Oh.
See, that's the part of the game they miss.
Exactly.
See, you have to be willing to serve. Like I shared some time ago, you know, you got to be willing to pass out flyers before you could be on the flyer to be able to do what needs to be done.
Right. I like
you know,
that.
A lot of times, boys don't want to pay those dues. And, you know, just on my way out, you said to, you know, to do you and know yourself and tap into yourself. Well, we understand if the Father and I is one, tapping into yourself is tapping into the divine essence that was already put in you from the first place.
Mm-hmm.
So if you don't do you, the way I look at it is you're disrespecting the divine nature that's within you.
Oh,
yes.
Wow. Say it, brother. Say it.
Amon, hang tight. Hang with us. We'll take this for. We have to take a quick commercial break. Amon, stay with us. We'll talk with you during the commercial. Guys, keep it locked. We'll be right back.
Know someone with a drinking or drug problem? Learn how to get sober after we share these stories.
I was 35 with two beautiful children when my life and addiction started to spiral out of control. After my divorce, I went into a depression cycle and started drinking more often and using prescription drugs. After my second DWI and arrest, my ex-husband threatened to take our children away from me.
I was 17 when I became addicted to heroin and meth. I thought I could quit on my own, but I couldn't. It hit me when I was arrested.
Get sober now. Your private insurance may cover costs, and we'll get you here. It's simple. Just call Elite Rehab Placement right now. Please, don't wait. Your life matters to us. 800-819-8313. 800-819-8313. 800-819-8313. That's 800-819-8313.
So much. You have tuned into the Be Incredibly Well Morning Show. So grateful for you guys. Thank you for so much. If you are out and about, questions 832-230-5592. Facebook, keep your questions and comments coming. We have Amon live on the air. I mean, on the phone with us. So, Amon, are you there?
I am right here.
Thank you for hanging on, Amon.
It's all good.
Sorry. Will you finish your thought for us? I'm sorry.
The main thing was that I've caught different segments. I'm bouncing around, obviously about to get ready to go teach my class here in just a second. But you know, it's just Brother Bo just kept coming with more and more. It was just more and more just resonating within me as you know we're all trying to be great, we're all trying to be better, trying to expand, trying to do more, be more and have more. But we also know that like the correlating part of that is that you got to serve more. If you if you solve more problems, if you become more of the solution,
mm-hmm.
Well, that's how you get more. You know, a lot of people say, you know, when I get it, I'm gonna give it. Well, that's why you'll never get it because you're not willing to give from what you got. You know,
wow.
And obviously
in
there's
time,
always
in time.
You know,
I mean, Ahmad, I will I'll say this, and then obviously we can definitely continue this conversation at another time. But I'm a firm believer that everything you do for yourself will die with you. Everything you do for someone else has a chance to live forever.
Whoa.
Whoa.
And I'll repeat it. Everything you do for yourself, when they close that casket, it will die with you. Everything you do for someone else has a chance to live forever.
Amon, you are awesome. Thank you
so much for
calling in this morning.
Hey, I appreciate
Thank
y'all.
You, Amon.
Being incredibly
man.
Well
appreciate
today, Amon.
Thank you. Y'all be well.
All right.
Thank you. Wow. One more time.
Everything you do for yourself will die with you. Everything you do for someone else has a chance to live forever.
Powerful.
Because they'll pass that blessing to the next person and the next person. When you do for other people, it puts something in them to continue to do for someone else because they know where their blessings came from.
All the more reason for us to go time. Time
is like, and what that makes me think about, man, is like one of my former teammates, Merton Hanks.
Yes.
With the San Fran 49ers.
One of my best friends in the whole world.
One of your best friends in the whole world. Saw him at the event, man, at the luncheon, man, which was an awesome legacy luncheon. Hadn't seen Merton in like 18 years. And I remember how he was a blessing to me. And how, just talking with you earlier, how he was a blessing to you. I remember I had these beat-up cleats on that I wore while I played ball at Baylor. Mm-hmm. And Merton saw my cleats. He was like, Ty, bro, I need you to retire those cleats. I'm like, no, Merton, these cleats are mine. They're comfortable and they're broken in. I love these Nike short cleats. Dude, they're going to be with me for a lifetime. He's like, dude, come by the locker.
Exactly.
I have a contract with Nike. Mm-hmm. I'm going to take care of it.
And now, and again, you see, and I said this to Ty when we were off the air, but I'm going to say it on the air. When I first went to University of Iowa, I arrived there the summer of 1990. Mm-hmm. I actually lived with Merton and Marvin Hanks. So Merton took me under his wing. So now Merton graduates. And what happens? Bo Porter, I take Damian Robinson under my wing.
Right.
I take Kerry Cooks under my wing. I take Tommy Knight under my wing.
Right.
And then I move on. I take Rashard Carter under my wing. And what did those guys do? They continue to take players under their wing. The cycle just continues because we all realize that we are being blessed to bless others.
Absolutely.
And that's why I brought that up.
Yes, it's a great point.
That. And be encouraged today. So whoever's listening and whoever's viewing us live, who can you take under your wing?
That's a great point.
Yes. So, my goodness. Let's go there, Ty.
I mean, Bo, man, you're doing a lot of different things, man. You're an awesome brother, man. I appreciate
Thank you, brother.
Appreciate
Thank you,
you for what you do. I mean, you got your books. You have multiple books. You have the Real Life Empowered. You have the End Game. I mean, so talk about your books, man. Talk about your products, man. It's about you right now.
Well, and actually, it's not about me. I can't even claim it. These are projects that God put on my heart. As first, I'll go with the Real Life Empowered. Again, it started as a book club message, in which I was sending out on a weekly basis, on a daily basis, rather, to my players that I was coaching.
Yes.
That then expanded from my players to people in their network, to more coaches and more players. And before I know it, the group that started with like 20 people ended up being like 1,900 people that were receiving this message every morning. And, you know, Tony Dungy, who was, you know, one of my biggest friends, and you look at the work in which he's done, his book actually encouraged me to do a daily devotional because I felt like this was a way for me not to only touch the people in which I was in direct contact with.
Yes.
It gave me an opportunity actually to spread my territory.
Mm-hmm.
So God put that on my heart. And when you look at Real Life Empowered, it's from the Empowered acronym, you know, basically that maps out the 9 different things of whole person development.
Mm-hmm.
And it's a daily devotional that basically you have a scripture, you have a daily quote, and then you have what's called a reism that actually ties the scripture in a quote to a real-life application.
And let me say this, a 365-day.
Yes. It's every day. It's, you know, again, it's 3 to 5 minutes a day. It's touching that intimate relationship with Christ that we talked about. And then you go from, you know, the real-life empowered to the end game. And many people that may look at that book, they actually may think that it's just a straight baseball or sports book. But you have to really open it up and dive into it to realize that when you look at the meaning of the book, it's the reason we play sports.
Right. Mm.
It's the responsibility of all parties involved when you sign up for sports. It is the reality of sports in that 99% of the kids that play youth sports, they will never play that sport professionally. But there's so often that when we're working with kids, we're stressing playing the big leagues, playing the NFL, playing the NBA.
Right.
When that really shouldn't be the message, because 99% of them are not going to play in that league, but they're going to live in society. Mm. So are we really trying to develop professional players, or are we trying to develop professional people? So when you look
at
that, it goes to the reward of sports, in which the reward centers around what we all really should try to seek and aspire to be from all of the lessons in which sports afford us to learn. And one of the things that you learn in team sports is to be selfless. So when you think about being selfless, if you learn that from sports and you basically implement it in all the other aspects of your life, you will make the world a better place.
Where can we get a copy?
You can get a copy on realexcellenceinc.com. So you go to www.realexcellenceinc.com. It's also on Amazon. We actually, have it on ebook as well. So you can log onto the website and you can get the book.
Yes. And we'll also add it to the post, the different locations, the websites. And is there...
I gave both of you guys a copy.
Yeah, man.
I know.
I'm
excited.
I'll give you a copy of both books.
Yes. Hey, and I want to show mine really quick.
You know, bearing gifts, man. Such a giver, man.
Right?
You know what I mean?
Love it.
Yes.
It's Christmas in February.
Guys, powerful, powerful discussion. I hope you have enjoyed our discussion with Mr. Bo Porter, Special Assistant to the General Manager of the Atlanta Braves today with regards to purpose, perseverance, and patience. I mean, I have been blown away. Ty, what about you?
Man, I mean, he did it.
We already knew that.
You guys are really good. I'm just a part of the supporting cast. Yes.
We appreciate you, Bo, for stopping in today. Just absolutely amazing. Awesome man of God. We appreciate you. And I want to tell you that Ryan Terry told me to tell you hello. I just talked to him this week.
RT, that's my man.
Yes. So next week,
that's another Hawkeye.
Ryan Terry and Anthony Vasquez will be live in the studio with us. Another great, great segment. We're all about you and every aspect of you and empowering your life. So we wish you a great weekend and be incredibly well. Take care, guys.
Great show.
The views and opinions expressed on KYND 1520 Talk programs are those of the host, guest, and callers, and are not necessarily those of this station, its owners, management, other hosts, or advertisers. Show topics on this station may include conversations on any lifestyle, belief, religion, political affiliation, or other personal practices. KYND, a Synergy Broadcasting Company. KYND 1520, KYNDradio.com.
Hey now, this is Amber Shaw inviting you to join me Sunday afternoons for Unplugged Praise. You'll get a dose of industry news, artist interviews, and music from some of your favorite artists such as John P. Key, Pastor Shirley Caesar, Marvin Sapp, and I can't forget about my Houston Gospel fam, Angela Bennett, Chad Brawley, Kathy Taylor, Wallace Grant II, and the list goes on and on. So tell your family, friends, and all your church members, Unplugged Praise is your kind of praise.
Unplugged Praise with Amber Shaw, Sundays 1 to 4 p.m. here on 1480 KLVL.
If you have an IRS issue, call Roderick Dial PC, 713-862-4332. My name is Roderick Dial, and I am a CPA, Certified Public Accountant. I'm in Houston, and I will speak to you myself. I can assist you with unfiled tax returns, audits, appeals, installment agreements, payment plans, liens, levies on your wages, bank account, and other IRS problems. Don't speak to the IRS yourself. Get professional representation. We also do income tax preparation. We don't promise you we will settle your tax debt for pennies on the dollar. The IRS is not giving away the bank. If you are serious about your IRS matter, call me. If we represent you, you generally never speak or meet with the IRS. Call for your free 15-minute phone consultation. I'm Roderick, and I want to take this burden off your hands. 713-862-4332. 713-862-4332. I'm Roderick, and let me help you with your tax issue.
Memories and more. Better than ever before.
Better than ever before.
With a different show every day.
Monday.
We go back in the day with all of your old school favorites on a more memory Monday.
Tuesday.
It's going to be a party.
It's Two-Steppin' Tuesday. It's Two-Steppin' Tuesday with Zodico.
Country and Western, Southern Soul, and Blues.
Wednesday.
It's a wide open Wednesday. That's the day we have a little bit of everything, including you, to talk about all the things we do.
Thursday.
Thursdays are always special with many specialty shows.
Friday.
It's the Friday Showdowns when your favorite artists battle it out and you determine the winner.
Memories and more.
Memories and more.
Better than ever before.
Better than ever before.
Coming soon to 1480. KLVL, Pasadena, Houston, 1480 AM and 95.3 FM.
Pearland, Sugarland, Kingwood, Katy, Acres Homes, Third Ward, The Heights, Friedmanstown, Sunnyside, Summerwood, Missouri City, Baytown, Crosby, and surrounding areas.
We are one. No matter what we do, we are one.
Harvey had strength, but we have power.
On the bachelor, yeah. I know you got a pass that's in the back of us. Ooh. Average, I'ma make a million on the average. Yeah. I'm riding with no brain, I'm out
Do
of it.
You slide on all your nights like this? Do you try on all your nights like this?
I might
put some spotlight.